This is episode 10 of Blue Hose Break, featuring head football coach Steve Englehart, women's soccer seniors Kelly Hall, Gwen Kaiser, Sophia Thompson, Madison Hindman, and Sarah Diefendurfer, and men's soccer seniors DeMorney Hutchinson, Carson Griffith, Damian McGregor Wickham, and Rude Monin. This episode of Blue Hose Break is sponsored by Scotty's Kids Club.
First, a lot of credit to Drake. You know, they've been a really good football team, you know, they got 15 wins in a row now in PFL. You know, they find a way to pull out a win. Maybe when they shouldn't have won, you know, type of thing. You know, I feel like, you know, we played well enough to win. A lot of credit to our kids. I mean, they came out and they played really, really hard, you know, played tough. And that's one thing that I'll say about our guys, you know, over the last, you know, several years. You know, they show up every week. You know, our kids show up every single week. They prepare. They work really hard in practice. You know, they stay together. They stay connected. And they keep showing up on Saturdays. And they play. Then they play extremely hard. And there's no give up, you know, in our team. And there won't be any give up, you know, this week either. Obviously, they're devastated, you know, with another close loss. You know, you look over the last 4 weeks and, you know, we can all pick, you know, a play or two out of, you know, all of those four games that went a little different. And we're sitting here at 4-0 right now, and it's a totally different conversation. And our kids had high expectations, high goals at the beginning of the year, you know, to win a PFL championship. And but that hasn't changed the way that they've continued to work, you know, every week. So it was a tough game. Obviously, I knew it was going to be a low scoring game. We had opportunities, you know, to get points on the board. I figured that it was going to be, you know, less than 20 on both sides, and field goals were going to be very important. Obviously, we missed a field goal early. We get the turnover off the muff punt return by Drake, and we get great field position, and we can't get it in the end zone. We have three critical errors right in a row on offense. It forces us a field goal, and then we miss the field goal, and then we miss an extra point. So may have been another opportunity within that game to kick another field goal. I went for it on fourth down one time. We just didn't have a lot of confidence in putting points on the board the last four weeks. And this is by no way singling out our kicking unit, but it's just reality that we have to get some things fixed on our kicking unit. In the last 4 weeks, we've either missed or have gotten blocked four extra points and four short field goals. And, you know, that's 16 points, you know, in the last 4 weeks that changed the course of our season and changed the course of our games. And we've got to be better at putting points on the board. And once again, it's not singling out that unit. It's just a reality, because we all know that the offense needs to find, you know, better ways to in the red zone to get touchdowns instead of field goals. But even if you look at last year, you know, we win the Dayton game in overtime on a field goal. So, you know, I think that the points are just critical in this league. The margin of error is very, very small, and the points are critical. So, you know, that's the situation we're in right now, and we've got to get it fixed, and our guys are going to go to work and be better at it this week, and we'll see what happens versus Stetson this week. And our entire team competes really hard. Defense is really, particularly the last 3 weeks. I think defensively we started a little bit slow. I think that we've gotten back to who we are on defense the last 3 weeks. And in particular, just, you know, the way that they practice, the things that we're doing that are kind of, you know, scheme-wise as well, have gotten back to kind of who we are. And I think coming into this year, we were so high on our defense, maybe a little pressure, you know, thought that they would just show up and didn't really probably do some of the things that we've done in the past in regards to preparing them. Because, you know, ultimately as a head coach, you know you have a lot of guys coming back and you have experience, and you go through camp, you go through those first couple weeks, and you just want to get them to the first game, you know, just get them there without injury. So but we've gotten back to the toughness that we play with on defense and tackling much better. Obviously, the way we're stopping the run, the way our defensive front is playing, creates a lot of other opportunities. When you take away the run game and force people into throwing the ball, then you can, you know, send pressures and other pressures to get to the quarterback, and our DBs are playing pretty well right now. We put them in a lot of different situations, whether it be zone or man coverages, and I think our defense is playing really connected right now, and we'll need that to continue to happen these next 4 weeks to end up the season. Every game in the league is gettable, and I think that every coach in this league feels the same way because of the parity in this league. And you know, we've played what we feel like to be, you know, traditionally some of the top teams in this league, and feel like we should have came away with wins. You know, when you talk about Davidson, you talk about San Diego, and now Drake, who's won 15 in a row. I mean, all these. So I feel like every game is gettable, and there's always going to be matchup situations and matchup, problems that you have to, you know, address during the week in practice. And if we can do that, obviously, I think that Stetson has a lot of really good skill players, particularly on offense. They're wide receivers. They throw the ball around. So it's a little bit different than what we've seen so far this year, maybe going all the way back to Mercer and how they throw the ball. And so, and even Mercer was different than the way Stetson, attacks it with their passing game. But you know, I think every game is gettable. There is not. I believe 2 weeks ago that we would. Win six in a row. I believe last week that we would win five in a row. I believe this week that we'll win four in a row. We have to find a way to get over the edge. And we talk about how you finish a game, and certainly that's it. But there's so many things that happen throughout the course of the game, where if any one of those plays happen differently throughout the course of the game, you know, we're sitting there at the end of the game in a different situation. So, but we do have to find a way to finish. And what better week to do it, you know, than this week? You know, it's important. It's important that we figure out a way, and we'll continue to do not only what we always do in practice, but we'll continue to switch things up a little bit and put our guys in some pressure situations in practice this week to get them to feel that pressure, so we have a better chance of finishing the game.
It's been really special getting to grow with these girls, and we've definitely created strong bonds, especially in the past year. There have been so many changes, but it's been really cool to see how we can all come together and lead the team to so much success through hardships and tough times. It's been super cool just to see how much we could grow in such a short amount of time. And you know, I wish that we could have had more time to grow together, but I'm glad that we could make the most, and we'll keep making the most of what we have in these next few days. I think it was our sophomore year, we beat High Point at High Point on their senior night, and that was really cool. But then when I think a little bit more about it, my freshman year in the spring, we played against my sister, and that was a really cool moment, cool family gathering. That was special too.
I definitely think that our class has gotten closer over the past year, just with a lot of changes within our program and everything. I would say our past few years weren't always the easiest sometimes, so it's been special that we've always been there for each other throughout these 4 years and everything. It was also kind of weird with our freshman year coming in, because it was during COVID and everything, so we didn't really know each other as well coming in. But we've definitely gotten to grow together as people, and I think it's really cool to see just how much we've matured and grown together, and the people that we've became since our freshman year. And it's just a cool experience to get to do it with such cool people. And I think especially my time here at PC, it's been with a lot of people that I hold close to my heart, and I've met a lot of really just special people that I know are going to be lifelong friends. So I'm very grateful for that. And just being able to finish off my career here, not exactly how I expected to, but it's been really special to have people like that in my life. It would definitely be having my first collegiate goal against Furman to win the game. It was a really special moment, and I never thought that that would happen to me, honestly, but it was really special because I guess I kind of surprised myself in a way, but it was cool to see myself grow as a person and a soccer player just overall. I think everyone's super excited. Obviously, the energy's high with only 2 games left in the regular season right now, so I think everyone has been putting in their extra efforts on and off the field, whether you're able to play or not able to play. Everyone's been pitching in and doing what they need to do, and definitely just trying to finish out the regular season strong for each other. And especially in our last match against Longwood, I think that it was very evident that we all play for each other, and just the team chemistry that we've built and our team atmosphere, which is very important to us.
Definitely the relationships I've formed here at PC, I'll carry on with me the rest of my life. Not only my other people I've come in with, but the rest of the team as well. I really have them to thank for my experience here. Without them, it wouldn't have been as good as it was, but I'd just like to thank all of them for making it what it was, especially in the circumstances that we've had throughout the years. It wouldn't just be like one specific memory, it would definitely be like just hanging out in the locker room with my teammates before practice, before games. But yeah, definitely just hanging out with my teammates. We've had a lot of hardships the past couple years, but it's really nice to see us putting in the hard work and getting the rewards that we are putting, the hard work for the rewards we're putting in. But it's nice to see people wanting to push themselves for their teammates.
At the beginning of my career, I wasn't exactly sure if PC was the place for me. But the longer I was here and the more I got to know my teammates and my fellow seniors, I just grew as a person, and I knew this place was actually good for me, and it's been super fun getting to know everybody. And it's just like family. It would definitely be beating Wofford 3 years in a row. Matt and Kerr have been great. They definitely brought a positive atmosphere to the team, and it has shown in the results, and I'm just not ready for it to be over. Hopefully we'll be in the Big South tournament and maybe even the championship. So
like you said, we came in at the end of COVID, so we never got an official visit together. And so I feel like that made coming into preseason just a little bit awkward because we never really got that time all together to bond. But I would say like every year, just everything that we've gone through, we've gotten closer every year. And especially my teammate Kelly, we've gotten a lot closer, like became roommates and best friends. So I'm really grateful for her, and that's definitely a relationship that I'll have outside of college for sure. And even with like Maddie, Gwen, and Sove, I felt like this past year, more than anything, we've gotten a lot closer being seniors on the team and like having to step up into leadership roles. So I'd say over every year we've just kind of gotten closer and closer, and I'm really grateful for them and love them, and I know that we'll be supporting each other like past college and past the season. Yeah, probably one of the biggest moments of like my soccer career was scoring against Georgia my freshman year. I think just like being a freshman and doing something like that, super crazy, but also just like the atmosphere of that game. I just remember having so much fun, and then just scoring that goal was just so crazy. That's like a very clear memory for me, and I definitely look back fondly on it. Yeah, so scoring against Georgia for sure. I think Matt and Curve has brought such a positive change to the team. We've always been there, and I just felt like them coming onto the scene just helped take us to the next level. I feel like we just believe in ourselves so much more, and that has just helped us. Like, we've always had the skill, but we've just come together a lot more this season, and the preparation, everything has just helped us.
I would say my favorite moment is, you know, just having a chance to spend time outside of the field with my teammates, you know what I mean? Especially when we can have like team dinners and, you know, just bond and, as a family, and also on our way back from games that we win, and the excitement and the togetherness we have as a team and as a group, you know what I mean? I think that is really special, and that is what we look forward to every time we go out there and play. And so, yeah, I think that's my most favorite memory, I can say, yeah. This is a program that has I'm blessed to be a part of, especially with these three guys, you know what I mean, senior guys. Every day I can say they come out in training and in games and they give it their 150% every single time, you know what I mean? I can't say there's a moment where I ever think they're not, you know what I mean, giving their full effort. So I really commend these guys. I really, you know what I mean, look up to these guys. You know what I mean? I appreciate all the work they put in for this team and the program, and also helping me to achieve everything I've achieved at PC, you know what I mean? And I hope I help them to achieve the same goals, you know what I mean? So I think it's an honor to play these guys, and it was really great. A big thank you to all of them, you know. They come out every single game and they show us their full support, you know what I mean? Even when it's really cold or when it's really hot, they always stood up, they cheer for us, they give it their all, you know what I mean? It's like a 12-man, you know what I mean? So I really appreciate everyone that comes out and support the team and the group and the family. So yeah, thank you.
My favorite memory probably from this year is probably the win against Coastal. That was a major win for us, and to have that feeling after the win, it was great being with the guys celebrating in the locker room and everything. So I'd definitely say the win against Coastal. It's meant everything. We've had, you know, it's been a tough run and stuff, but we've always, you know, stuck together and pushed out for each other, and always fought for each other during when it got tough and stuff like that. So it's been good. It's been an honor to play with these guys and play with the rest of my teammates. So all I can say is thank you. Blue Hose fan, just all I can say is thank you. It's been a great, I've been here for almost 2.5 years now, and coming in from PC, I transferred in, you know, and I didn't know what to really expect, and all I can say is positive things about this place, and it's been great for me, and this has been my home for the past 2.5 years, so all I can say is thank you to everybody.
I have two, specifically the win against Asheville last year, 3-2, and then the win this year against Coastal away from home, 3-2 again. Like two massive wins on the road that really meant a lot to me and the guys. It's been a true blessing and honor, honestly. Like, I've been able to grace the field with a lot of guys who have a lot of talent, and I've learned a lot from them, especially the seniors. So just being able to share a lot of tough moments, you know, I've learned a lot from them, and I can't wait to see what happens next. I love each and every one of the fans that come out to the games. Everyone has continued to show support during our ups and downs. And those fans, you know, they mean a lot to us, and we just try to win as many games as possible for them, and, you know, ask them to continue to keep supporting us even as we graduate and we move on.
I have a lot, but one of my best is going to be this year against Coastal, because the team didn't give up. We keep fighting until the end, and we won the game away. So everyone celebrated in the locker room. It was amazing. It was a really great sensation, and I think that's my best memories. But this guy, it was amazing to play with them. Good mentality, never give up, always there for help each other, you know. They was always push everyone for the best of the team, and very, very thank you to them, because they teach me a lot about myself, and even like for the team, it was a pleasure. A big thank you to all of the fans, because we can, like, they was there always, even when we was playing away, the people was making the trip. See them against Virginia Tech when it's 4 hours from our school and stuff like that. It was really like a big thank you to all of them, and keep going, support the Blue Hose family.